Hello everyone, this is Moshe the Electric Israeli and thank you for joining my channel. If you're new, please subscribe and help me change the world one electric car at a time. Thank you to all of my patrons, supporters, subscribers, and those who buy their Tesla using my referral code. Much appreciated. And now that I have the Tesla Model Y for over 1400 miles, I took it to two nice trips, not the big ones yet. The big one is coming and the huge one is coming later. Want to reflect a little bit about the real world mile. And as you know, if you are part of this channel and you watch it every day, and I know that some of you do, you know that I do not sugarcoat anything. I tell the truth as much as I can about real world range. Now, notice, before I get to it, notice that in the last few years, nobody talks about range anxiety anymore. That was the talk. Tesla will fail because of range anxiety. What are you going to do when you get out of town? Okay, well, that issue was put to bed, put to rest, buried, and never cut, and no resurrection to that issue, thank the Lord. Because of the supercharging and because of the charging infrastructure, both the United States and around the world, I drive this car everywhere. I never worry about anything to do with range anxiety, so let's not even bring it up. Now, when you talk about real-world range, and I only test my cars in real-world condition, summer, winter, you know that the factors of real-world range is speed. Speed is a huge factor. You can have an average of 350 watt-hour per mile if you drive 80 miles per hour and drop it to probably 280 or even 250 if you drive 65 miles an hour. And if you drive 60, you can get even lower than that. Or 55, you can get lower than that. You can get to 180 watt hour per mile if you drive 55 miles an hour on the highway. I mean, good luck being on the grandma lane, but that you can do that. Temperature is humongous. In the winter, it takes tremendous amount of energy to heat the cabin and to move the car forward. You can lose 20, 30, or even 50% of the range. Weight, how many people are in the car? Are you towing something? Do you have something on the roof that drags it? So those are some of the most important factors in real world range. So which is better? My Tesla Model 3, which I'm now, the rear wheel 325 rated range, or my Tesla Model Y, the 316 rated range. So you see that it's not a big discrepancy in real world range. Now you will never see, if you charge your Tesla Model Y, you will never see 316. Maybe 310, maybe a little more, who knows? It's never, I never saw 325 here. It used to be 310 also, I never saw that either. So, you know, it fluctuates, the real world range. But let's just play the game and say 325 rated range here and 316 over there. Which one gets the best real world range? And I can tell you, from driving this car to Florida twice, 3,000 miles each time, Canada, driving it all around, mega trips, I can tell you the average watt hour per mile, which is a great indicator of what you do, is between 300 and 350 winter or summer. So lower in the summer, obviously bigger in the winter. So far with the Model Y, I got to 260, 250, 270 once, 280. So it's much lower. Why is that? Obviously it's better technology, battery management, all that. And of course the heat pump, which Tesla Model Y is the only car that has a heat pump, it is a huge factor. I cannot wait to see it in the winter. Now I do have great experience with heat pump in the winter because my Nissan Leaf, my old Nissan Leaf, used to have a heat pump, and the range in the winter was not that different than the summer. Now here in this Model 3, I know that at 32-35 degrees Fahrenheit, obviously, which is 0 to 7 degrees Celsius, you would lose 20-30% range in the Model 3. Conversely, in the Model Y, which has the heat pump, I venture that the difference between the winter driving and the summer driving will not be that great. Of course, we will test it, obviously. But I can tell you, for my Nissan Leaf, which had a whopping 85 miles rated range, love that car, there was not that much. I used to lose like 5 or 10 miles real world range in the winter with the because of the heat pump. So we'll see. So I can tell you right off the bat that the Model Y gets right now, from what I test real world range, 260. I can get it to even 270 if I try to squeeze it. This car, which has more rated range, will probably get 240, 250, okay, 220, 200 in the winter, depending on, again, all the factors that I mentioned, especially temperature and speed. Those are elevation, of course. Those are big factors. So this is my prediction. I cannot wait for a really nice cold winter with a lot of snow and to see how the Model Y does in the winter. Those of you who tested it already in the winter, if you can share your result, that would be great. Thank you guys for watching. Put your comments below, and I'll see you tomorrow.